Today's cameras do a pretty outstanding job of shooting quality video. However, sometimes you might want to add a little more pizzazz to a clip than what your camera or video editor produces. To accomplish that, you can use tone mapping. Generally, tone mapping is used to combine images of different exposures to produce high dynamic range images. But you can use the same software to turn an average image into one that attracts more attention. How does it work with a video? A video is nothing more than a bunch of images played back rapidly. When doing time-lapse, we shoot single images, normally with a fixed interval, and then put them into an editor as a video clip to produce a video. We can do a circular process to use our HDR software to process all those frames in our video and then put them back into the editor as a time lapse. The editor creates a video from the newly tone mapped images. I'll be using Vegas Movie Studio Platinum and EasyHDR 3 for this process. I'm using VideoShot with a DJI Phantom 3 Advanced and a Sony RX10 4. For this exercise, the video clips are usually fairly short, about 10 seconds. I have Movie Studio open, and I'll drag the Sample 1 clip into the original clip's media bin. Then I'll drag it to the timeline and select No in response to the question. Once on the timeline, I want to create separate frames from the clip. I select Project, Render As, Image Sequence, and select JPEG as the template. Select the folder and provide the name template for the frames and click Render. Depending on the size of the clip, the process may take a few minutes. When the images have been rendered, I am finished with the original clip and can remove it from the project. Now, I want to apply tone mapping to the images I just rendered. For that, I use EasyHDR 3. I want to start by creating a custom enhancement for the images, so I drag one of the images onto the program. Leave lens correction as manual, but don't click it so we don't change this. I'll leave noise filtering on at the default values, then I click on LDR enhancement. The program processes the image and provides a look at the default adjustment. This frequently is just what you want. It does not look artificial, but produces an image with more snap. I can compare the original to the processed image by clicking on the split screen icon. On the right side, we have a variety of adjustments we can make to change the image to what we like. On the left side, we have a variety of preset adjustments from which we can select. Some produce tasteful images and some don't. If we want a special effect, we can choose that and modify as needed and save as a new adjustment by selecting the Presets tab and clicking the plus icon and then name the setting. When we have saved the adjustment, we just close the current project without saving, since we want to run a batch on all the images. Then, I click on the batch icon, the gear, to open the batch processing window. To create the multiple tasks needed to process all the images, I click Auto Create Tasks. The Tasks tab is open and I enter the path to the images. I select each task as a single image file, LDR enhancement. Then I click OK and a task will be created for each image. On the Tasks tab, I select the preset I want. I'll use the one I previously saved as hospital. On the Options tab, I need to set the Save To location to Custom, so my images go to a separate folder, and select JPEG as the type of image. I'll leave the other default settings as they are set. Finally, I click Run All and let the program process all the images. When the processing is done, I close the program and verify that the images have been saved. Next, I open Movie Studio. To get the images into Studio as a clip, you select Project, Add Media, and go to the folder containing the images you want to add. Click on the first image. This will indicate the number of images in the sequence. Then click the Open Sequence box and click Open. In the Properties window, you can give the tape a name, but it is not a requirement. I'll leave it blank and use the default values for all boxes and click OK. This will bring the images in as a video clip. It shows a single icon for the imported images. If I look at Images by Type and look at Stills, there are no icons. But under Video, the icon for the images appears, indicating it really is a video clip. I can then do anything with the clip that I would do with any regular video clip. Here are some comparisons of original and tone-mapped clips produced with this process. If you enjoyed this video or found it useful, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for viewing.